Good morning to all of you. Students, today we will start one chemistry experiment for standard 11th. Our experiment is volumetric analysis. First of all, what is volumetric analysis? For volumetric analysis, it is the method to determine concentration of solution in terms of normality or molarity. If concentration of other solution is known, the other solution whose concentration is known as standard solution. You already know how to prepare standard solution. Today we are going to use 0.1 normal standard solution of oxalic acid. That will be used to determine the normality of sodium hydroxide solution. So aim of the experiment is to determine normality of sodium hydroxide by using standard solution of oxalic acid. For this volumetric analysis, the method used is titration. Titration means the solution is allowed to pass through burette and allowed to react with the solution in the conical flask. So this is the titration. For this experiment, first of all we will see what are the required apparatus. You can observe this burette stand. This burette stand is used to fix burette for the volumetric experiment. This is 25 ml burette. You can observe marking from 0 up to 25. So this is known as 25 ml burette. This is the top of the burette from which we are going to pour the solution. And this is the tip of the burette. Above this tip, this is known as nozzle of the burette. By using this knob, we can allow the solution to pass through this nozzle. If this is horizontal, we can close the knob. If this is vertical, that means solution can pass through this burette. That means it is open. Close. Open. Always keep it close when you are not using. This burette we can keep into this burette stand. Now, for pouring the solution into the burette, we can use this funnel. So funnel is important for transferring the solution into the burette. For taking exact amount of acid, this pipette is used. You can observe this pipette. This is the top of the pipette and this is the tip of the pipette. From tip, if you go upside, you can observe this bulb of the pipette. So above this bulb, you can observe one marking. Up to this marking from tip, this is 10 ml pipette. So with the help of this pipette, we can take solution for this analysis. This is small conical flask. We are using this small conical flask for titration or for volumetric analysis. So this conical flask is known as volumetric flask or titration flask. So these are all required apparatus for volumetric analysis. You can observe a flask contain oxalic acid, B flask contain NaOH solution. We will fill NaOH solution. Before that, first wash all the apparatus required for the experiment. So washing of the apparatus, first take burette. Let us wash burette thoroughly. Whenever you are washing any apparatus, take care of apparatus carefully and see for burette this knob is closed. Then you take 1 conical flask. First of all, wash this conical flask. Wash it. And then take water into conical flask to pour water into the burette for washing. Wash this funnel with water. Keep the funnel on the burette to wash the burette with water. The knob is closed so that we can pour water from this funnel. Now wash it thoroughly with the help of finger from top to bottom. Then remove water from the nozzle so that nozzle will be washed thoroughly. Now let us remove water from this burette. So our washing procedure will be over. Now nozzle of this burette is also washed. You can remove from back side also because already the nozzle is washed with water. Close it and keep in burette stand. So washing of funnel, washing of conical flask and washing of burette over. Now we will wash the pipette. For this pipette, take this water in conical flask and pipette it for washing it. Then by using this index finger, close it so that water from this pipette will not flow from this pipette. So remove from this pipette, remove water from this pipette and also from back side. So pipette is washed thoroughly. So our washing of all the apparatus is over. Now, for this experiment, what are the observations? Just now we observed that burette solution is NaOH solution and flask solution is acid solution. So, since this experiment is based on concentration, we will rinse this burette with respective solution, that is NaOH, and pipette with oxalic acid solution. So, rinsing for this experiment is very important. So flask B in burette solution, now rinsing of the burette with NaOH solution. So for that, use this funnel, pour this NaOH solution only 5 to 6 ml just for rinsing. Before pouring the solution, check whether this nozzle is closed or not. Now for rinsing, take 5 to 6 ml and rinse it thoroughly. Again remove from the nozzle. So nozzle is also rinsed with NaOH solution. Now after rinsing the burette, we will rinse pipette because 10 ml of pipette we have to, 10 ml of oxalic acid we have to pipette for titration. So now I am going to rinse this pipette by oxalic acid. we are going to take 10 ml. Before that, let us rinse this pipette with acid. Take acid below this bulb and then rinse it thoroughly. Remove from backside. So the burette is washed with, rinsed with NaOH solution. Pipette is rinsed with oxalic acid solution. And we require conical flask for volumetric titration. But remember, all of you remember that conical flask should not be rinsed with any solution. This should be washed after each reading. To start the experiment, now we will take NaOH solution in the burette. Close the tap. Take above zero. With the help of funnel, this is B base NaOH solution in the burette, and then remove from the nozzle so that nozzle will be filled with NaOH solution. With that, you can adjust to zero mark also. Before adjusting to zero mark, I want to tell you one very important thing about these solutions. See, when we are performing this volumetric experiment, the solution can be colored or colorless. If the solution is colorless, always adjust to lower meniscus at the marking. Now we are adjusting this solution to zero mark. So adjust lower meniscus to this zero marking. If it is colored, then you have to adjust upper meniscus to this zero marking. So our solution NaOH is colorless. So let us adjust to lower meniscus. You can observe this lower meniscus at zero mark. Solution is passing through the nozzle and we are adjusting this NaOH solution with lower meniscus at zero mark. So it is exactly at zero marking. So our NaOH solution is in the burette. Take out this flask B of NaOH solution. Now take already washed conical flask to transfer this oxalic acid, 10 ml of oxalic acid, into this small volumetric flask. When you take this solution into the pipette, always take above this 10 ml marking. This marking. And then adjust with the help of index finger up to this mark with lower meniscus. Now adjust the lower meniscus of this solution up to the marking with index finger. And check any air bubble is present in the burette. Let us slowly adjust. Okay, so lower meniscus is at the marking. Transfer this solution into already washed conical flask. Remove index finger. Solution will flow into the conical flask. Now, you can observe this pipette, the tip of the pipette, you can observe the extra drop present. Please do not blow this extra drop. This is extra, no need to take. Just remove like this and keep it. Now, we have acid in conical flask and base in burette. Before starting this titration, what is the exact experiment? We are performing the reaction which is known as neutralization. What is neutralization? You know the neutralization definition, that is acid reacting with base gives salt and water. The same we are performing here. Here base is in the burette, acid is in the conical flask. We are allowing this base to react with acid. but exact definition of neutralization is H plus ions of acid reacts with OH minus ions of base and get neutralized and reaction is over. That means when the reaction, it is coming to completion of the reaction, we should understand the point. That point is known as end point. End point is the point at which reaction is completed. To understand that, both the solutions, acid as well as base, are colorless. So when the when acid is reacting with base, the solution obtained is also colorless. To understand the end point, we are using indicator. What is indicator? To detect the end point. Just we are using this phenolphthalein indicator. What is phenolphthalein? This phenolphthalein shows different color and different medium. It shows colorless solution in acidic medium and it shows pink color in basic medium. So we have this acid in conical flask and we are allowing this base to react with acid. So if we use phenolphthalein indicator in acid and when OH minus ions are reacting with acid, when an extra drop after the reaction, extra drop of OH minus ions after the reaction are mixing with this solution, phenolphthalein shows its pink color. That means we are getting the end point with pink color only. So let us see. Now this is acid. I am adding phenolphthalein indicator to detect the end point. Two drops are enough. Shake well. Now we will allow base to react with acid. When we are adding this acid to base to acid, it takes time to react. So we will not add this base continuously. We will add 1 ml each time approximately. Shake it well. Again we will add. Like that we will add this base till pink color appears. Now let's see. Always keep conical flask in your right hand and by using left hand on this knob of this nozzle, this way pass the base solution into the conical flask. Approximately 1 ml you can add at a time. So I am adding 0 to 1. Shake it vigorously. No color. Like that we can go on adding base till pink color appears. So now it is 1 to 2 ml. Shake vigorously. 2 to 3 ml. So we are adding 1 ml each time. Shake it well and check whether pink color is appeared or not. No pink color, still it is colorless. Now one more thing you can understand. See, we are using this tile. Because of this white tile, you can observe color in this volumetric flask while titrating under this burette also. So let us observe. See, pink color you can observe in the flask, but if you take out, it is not remaining. That means reaction is not completed. So more of OH minus ions of base are required for given volume of acid. Okay, so again we will add. While adding base, you can observe pink color, but after shaking, it disappears. Now we have reached up to 9 ml, but pink color is not there. after vigorous shaking also, pink color disappears. So again we have to add it. So students, observe this light pink color. This is the end point of the titration. Here you can observe end point colorless to light pink. By addition of base to acid, we are getting this light pink color. But if you add one more extra drop, it will become dark pink color. But we should take only this light pink color, because dark pink color shows that solution has become basic because of extra OH minus ions. And this is our neutralization experiment, neutralization reaction. We want neutral solution showing light pink color of the completion of reaction. So we will not take any dark pink color reading. This is our end point. Let us take reading. When you take the reading from the burette, I already explained, for colorless solution, lower meniscus should be observed. So this reading you should observe to your eye level. So this eye level is very important. If you take reading above this solution, then there will be parallax error. To avoid this parallax error, we will take this reading to at the eye level. So I am going to take this reading. This is 11.3 is the reading. Now you can understand how to write the reading in this observation table. You can observe the 6-point pilot reading. What is pilot reading? Pilot reading is the range in which we are getting the end point. If we know the range, that means we have 11.3, that means our reading is between 11 ml to 12 ml. So if we know our reading is between 11 to 12, for next reading we can add up to 10 ml continuous shaking, and after 10 we can add drop wise to get exact light pink color, so that we can take more than one reading to get the constant burette reading. What is constant burette reading? If two consecutive readings are same, that is known as constant burette reading. So students, our reading, burette reading 11.3, we will write here. Okay, so we already adjusted to zero mark in the burette, and we are getting 11.3 first reading. So from 0 to 11.3, the difference is 11.3. This way, same procedure we can repeat more than one time to get two consecutive readings same. That is known as constant burette reading. That constant burette reading we can write here. And this constant burette reading we will use to determine the normality of NaOH solution, because now we have volume of NaOH required for complete neutralization of 10 ml of 0.1 normal oxalic acid. So let us see calculation part now. The reaction is oxalic acid H2C2O4 dihydrate 2H2O reacting with NaOH. The reaction is sodium oxalate and water. If you balance this reaction, you will understand 2 moles of sodium hydroxide required for complete neutralization of oxalic acid. Now in calculation, we have oxalic acid versus NaOH. NaVa, N stands for normality, V stands for volume taken for the experiment, A stands for acid. So for oxalic acid, Na normality of oxalic acid, which is already known because of this standardization. So 0.1 normal oxalic acid is there. Then Va is volume of oxalic acid. We were pipetting out 10 ml of oxalic acid each time. That means volume of acid taken is 10 ml. So here You can observe this is volume of oxalic acid 10 equal to for NaOH N normality NB normality of base going to determine. And volume of base, base we have taken into the butyrate. So volume of butyrate that we obtained by titration is our constant butyrate reading. So NB equal to 0.1 into 10 divided by constant butyrate reading gives answer that is 0.088 normal. This is the normality of NaOH. But if the standard solution given is in terms of molarity, then we can find the molarity of unknown solution by other way. Let us consider that oxalic acid is 0.1 molar. Okay, 1 mole of oxalic acid required 2 mole of NaOH. This is obtained from the equation. This oxalic acid required 2 moles of NaOH. So, how much gram of NaOH is required? For 1 mole of oxalic acid, 2 into molecular weight of NaOH, that is 40. That means 80 grams of NaOH is required. So, if this solution is prepared, 1000 ml of 1 molar oxalic acid, it requires 80 grams of NaOH. But from 1 molar, if we have 0.1 molar standard solution of oxalic acid, then for that NaOH required is 0.08 grams. So 0.08 gram of NaOH is present in VB ml of NaOH, that means constant butyrate reading of NaOH. Then x gram of NaOH is present in 1000 ml of NaOH. We are taking it into 1000 ml to find out the molarity. For molarity, it should be converted to 1 liter. So x gram equal to 1000 into 0.08 divided by VB. This x gram is weight of substance in 1000 ml of solution. Okay, so this we will use to find the molarity of NaOH as we determine normality of NaOH in above calculations. So molarity of NaOH is equal to weight of substance in 1000 ml of solution divided by molecular weight of NaOH. That means molarity is equal to this x gram divided by molecular weight of NaOH, that is 40. So that gives the molarity of NaOH. So this is the way to find the concentration in terms of normality or molarity from the standard solution. I want to tell you some precautions to be taken for this experiment. When you take this butyrate solution before starting the experiment, there should not be any air gap in this butyrate. If air bubble or air gap is present in the butyrate, then there will be variation in the reading. And then only wash the conical flask, this volumetric flask which is having pink colored solution. Please do not wash butyrate and pipette again and again for each reading. Only pour the solution of NaOH up to this zero mark addressed to lower meniscus for each reading. Take 10 ml of pipette directly without washing and rinsing. Only wash conical flask again and again after each reading. These are important precautions. So this is all about the volumetric.